students, I welcome everyone for the gate doubt session on analog circuits. Myself, Professor Ankur, and I welcome everyone on behalf of EKIDA for the gate doubt session. First, before I start with the topic, I would like to give an intro regarding myself. I have been in this field of teaching for more than 13 years. I have been teaching GATE since the year 2013. And when I talk about a topic specifically regarding analog circuit, if you see the pattern of the questions will be coming for 1 mark and 2 mark, and sometimes even link question. As per the modern trend, you will find questions which are actually like you are supposed to directly find the unknown parameter. In that case, we are not given the option. So we have to fill the option. In this case, we don't have negative marking. Now, let's start with our first session on introduction to diode and basic diode circuits. This is our first session. So let's start with the session now. So now, before we actually start with the basic concepts of the diode circuitry, we need to actually understand the diode. Our main target is actually sum solving. But before we actually go for the sum solving, we need to understand the background of the topic. So I'll be giving you a small introduction regarding the device that we're going to use today in the various circuits. So the first thing is we need to understand the definition of diode. So everyone is aware regarding a diode. Diode is basically a semiconductor device that is made up of two regions. P region and N region. P region corresponds to the holes and the N region corresponds to the electrons. And at the center, we are having recombination of electron and hole that corresponds to your depletion region. It's a device with two terminals, anode and cathode respectively. Now, when we talk about the basic understanding, the first thing is we need to understand the characteristics. Unless and until we understand the characteristics, we will not be able to get an idea regarding what we are trying to actually solve. So when we talk about the diode characteristics, we need to understand the background of the diode with respect to the two aspects, that is the forward bias and the reverse bias. Many of us will like to think, what do you mean by actual meaning of biasing? So the most important point we need to understand that whenever we talk about the operation with respect to an external power supply, which is normally a DC power supply, that concept is called as biasing. So when you connect a diode with respect to the battery connection, there are two ways in which we can connect the diode, and that's the reason we are getting the two impacts, the forward bias and the reverse bias. So now when we talk about the arrangement of the diode with respect to the forward bias and the reverse bias, the detailed understanding of this will be with respect to the electronic devices. But then in short, we can understand very easily that whenever a diode becomes forward bias, it is going to conduct, and normally the conduction happens over a voltage about 0.7 volts, which we call as the forward voltage drop. Now, when we talk about the reverse characteristics corresponds to the effect of avalanche. When you try to realistically figure out what happens for forward and reverse, we normally say that under forward bias, the diode will work like a closed switch. And under reverse bias, the diode will work like an open switch. So when we talk about the reverse current is very, very small. And that current is going to be negligible. Normally that reverse saturation current is of the order of 10 raised to minus 8, 10 raised to minus 9, goes till 10 raised to minus 14, 15 ampere. So it's a very, very small negligible current, and that's the reason we say that a diode is not going to operate under reverse. We say it is going to work like an open switch. Now this property of the diode, like the closed switch behavior under forward bias and the open switch behavior in the reverse bias, helps us in solving various types of sums in analog circuits. So here we need to understand only two aspects: forward bias, ideal behavior of the diode, closed switch; reverse bias, ideal behavior of the diode, open switch. So this is the arrangement actually. So with respect to the diode under forward bias and reverse bias, we are having an arrangement here. So you can see the p-type and the n-type structure with p2 positive and n2 negative goes as forward bias, and p2 negative and n2 positive, it's called as reverse bias. So when you carefully observe the arrangement, you will find, and everyone is also aware regarding the operation now, it's like we are understanding diode since long. So in our mind, we are having one thing that in the forward bias, the diode will be conducting state. So we don't have the actual impact of the barrier. So the barrier is gone. And when we talk about the reverse bias, the barrier will be present. So the potential barrier will be corresponding to the width. So the width will keep on increasing as and when we go for rise in the reverse voltage. So, and then we are also aware regarding the forward bias. So when we talk about the forward bias, we get the current of the diode. That's a conduction current of the diode. And that's the reason we call it as a closed switch effect. And when you talk about reverse bias, it's the reverse saturation current, which is a current due to the minority. That's the main point we need to understand. When we talk about the forward biasing, the current contribution comes because of the majority carrier. And that's the reason we will get a significant current if you put an ammeter to get a reading of the current. And when we talk about the reverse bias, we definitely get very, very small current. But then when you put an ammeter, a practical ammeter might be available in your lab also. When you put equipments like that, even if it is milliampere or microampere, the coil of that will not show a deflection, indicating that the current is zero. But then if you put proper ammeters with minute configurations and better scaling, so they will give you a small, very, very small reading. And that's the reason we are getting a reverse characteristics graph. So that is something that we need to understand, that from where we are getting the reverse characteristics graph. So now, the next thing we need to understand here is the circuit arrangement. I'm trying to go a little bit more into the detail so that when we go to the sums, we are actually comfortable with the sums. So whenever we go for the sums, we need to have a proper background. So I am trying to create a background for everyone. I hope everyone is getting connected with me and you are able to interpret the situation. So I'll be going very slow so that I can help you out in all possible aspects. So here, when we talk about the forward biasing and the reverse biasing, two important points only to interpret here. Forward bias closed switch, reverse bias open switch. Under forward bias, the diode will retain a drop of 0.7 provided it's a silicon diode. We need to interpret the question carefully, because whenever we talk about germanium, we take the drop as 0.3. And when we talk about silicon, we take the drop as 0.7. Sometimes during the question itself, they will be providing a data regarding the forward drop of the diode. So in that case, we are not supposed to go for an assumption. We are directly supposed to take a data which is there from the question. Yeah, hello everyone. Yeah, hello. I hope everyone is getting the important aspect that I'm trying to discuss. And please be with me. We'll be definitely solving sums. Aap mere saath rahiye so that we can definitely go for the sums part. Please be with me. I know that you are actually comfortable with the initial part. Aapko aata hai, and that's great actually. The confidence part is good. But then we need to just go for a small revision. So that when we go for the sums, it should not be like ye cheez discuss nahi ho paya. So please be with me. Okay. Chalo, aage badhte. Theek hai. Now, so this is the aspect of forward bias and reverse bias. Diode ka connection. Anode to positive, cathode to negative. Most important point we need to understand, that how do you interpret the situation of forward and reverse? I'll give you a very simple interpretation. Under normal understanding, you can say anode voltage greater than cathode, we say it is forward. And if anode is less than the cathode potential, we say it is reverse. So this is a understanding with respect to the ideal background. But when we talk about the practical aspect, we say that the anode potential has to be greater than the cathode by a drop of 0.7. अगर आज कैथोड पे 2 वोल्ट है तो एनोड का पोटेंशियल जो है वो 2.7 वोल्ट से ज्यादा लगेगा, प्रोवाइडेड आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट द डायोड इज अ सिलिकॉन डायोड. यही सिचुएशन में यू विल सी दैट द डायोड विल बी फॉरवर्ड बायस. सो दैट्स द मेन पॉइंट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. इट्स नॉट लाइक कैथोड पे 2 वोल्ट है तो एनोड का डायरेक्टली 2 वोल्ट के ऊपर क्रॉस किया और उसने डायरेक्टली फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग दे दिया. ऐसा नहीं होता है. हमें क्वेश्चन को ठीक से इंटरप्रेट करना पड़ता है कि डायोड के लिए अजम्पशंस कुछ स्टेट किए हैं क्या, प्रैक्टिकल डायोड है या आइडियल डायोड है, उसके हिसाब से हमें पोटेंशियल के हिसाब से लॉजिक मिलेगा. ये जो सर्किट्स जो हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे आगे जाके, सो दे विल बी रिलेटेड टू द क्लिपर, क्लैंपर और बहुत से ऐसे डायोड सर्किट्स रहेंगे. सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट सच अरेंजमेंट, तो उसके लिए हमें वो डायोड का अंडरस्टैंडिंग रखना जरूरी है. सो कमिंग बैक, और रिवर्स के लिए मैंने बोला है कि एनोड शुड बी लेस देन द कैथोड, तो ऑटोमेटिकली यू विल गेट द इंपैक्ट ऑफ रिवर्स बायस. आइडियल बिहेवियर, डायोड फॉरवर्ड बायस क्लोज स्विच, रिवर्स बायस ओपन स्विच, ड्रॉप ऑफ 0.7 अंडर फॉरवर्ड बायस, एज आई हैव सेड, प्रोवाइडेड दैट द डायोड अज्यूम्ड इज अ सिलिकॉन डायोड. So going further, so this is again an important equation, which is the Shockley's equation, where you will find the current equation ID is equal to IS exponential of VD by nu times VT minus 1, where VT is called as thermal voltage. So we have the IS current, which is called as a reverse current. As I've said, the reverse current will be very, very small. You can observe it's almost 10 raised to minus 14 ampere, and nu is basically, or n you can say, it's corresponding to the emission coefficient. So when we talk about the emission coefficient is standardized to 1 for silicon germanium, and when we talk about gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide and all that, we take around 2 something. So you can say that the nu is fluctuating between 1 and 2, but for our normal calculations we normally take the emission coefficient as 1. Many of the times we don't even consider nu. Many of you might be not knowing also there is something which is called as nu, because bahut se textbook jo hai wo directly diode ka current equation le lete hain, IS exponential of VF by VT bolte hain usko. VF is actually VD only, the diode drop. Then the T corresponds to the absolute temperature. Then VT is corresponding to thermal voltage. So that's a main important point here. Thermal voltage is corresponding to impact of temperature effects on the diode operation. So it will definitely have an impact on the current. Everyone is aware regarding atom, or atom ke upar jo temperature effect jo aata hai, jaise temperature badhega to more number of electrons will get released from the valence band to the conduction band, so the conduction has to improve. So that's one of the important impact. So many of the students actually wonder that why such parameters are there in electronics, and it's not digestible, you can say. So the main thing we need to understand here is that whenever we talk about the electronics, we understand everything in terms of voltage, current and power. So jo bhi non-technical parameter hai, like pressure bolo, temperature bolo, ya fir humidity bolo, moisture bolo, field effects ke jo bhi hai bolenge. To ye sab impact jo hai hume study karne electronics mein, to we need an electronic proportionate for that. So that's the reason we are introducing such parameters, that they will be contributing to that. Then Q is the value of charge. Everyone is aware, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. And K is your Boltzmann's constant. That is 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 joule per degree Kelvin. Temperature, if I assume approximately 300 degree Kelvin, you will get VT, which is 25.86 millivolt. We are approximating it as 26 millivolt. That's a standard value of VT. But then depending on the data also, we will be calculating the value of VT if the data of the parameters is provided. So that's the main point regarding this diode equation. This equation is actually representing the forward bias effect of the diode. Ye jo bhi exponential behavior wagera jo bhi dikh raha hai, it's a impact of the forward bias current. Reverse mein, as everyone is aware, that we are considering the diode as open switch. So that's the reason actually, whenever we talk about the open switch effect, so we need to consider the reverse current almost zero, na ke barabar dikhte hain hum log aise, theek hai. So now going further, someone has asked, sir, each and every topic you will cover, the best, I will try to do the best possible thing that I can help you in actually. So whenever we get connected for a session, I'll always try to brief you something regarding the topic, and then we'll try to solve sums on that topic, so that you need to understand and get the flow of the topic. GATE exam is not an easy exam. It's a complicated exam. So the mindset has to be much clear. The conceptual background has to be much clear when you join a particular course. And that's the reason our organization EKIDA has taken a positive step to introduce doubt sessions for everyone, where we will be interacting live, and then we will be able to exchange our thoughts. So that will develop your understanding, and it will be helping you in getting better score. So that's the main point of our conversation here. So it's the same thing. The equation that I have discussed here is actually the same thing. The only thing is I am trying to discuss here is the representation. When you see the right hand side diagram, which is showing you the diode equivalent circuitry. So in the diode equivalent circuitry, I'll be taking questions from instrumentation also. Don't worry. The topics that we are trying to cover here are from EXTC, electrical and instru. So don't panic, guys. Just stay connected. Okay, relax. So here we are talking about the equivalent effect of the diode. So when we talk about the equivalent effect of the diode, the idealistic behavior, that's a closed switch behavior. Then we have the drop of the diode corresponding to 0.7. And then we also have an important parameter that is called as the forward resistance of the diode. During our degree phase, we normally never used to see such parameter, or we never use that value during calculation. But many of the time you will find that through the data, we will have to calculate the forward resistance of the diode, and that will be included in your circuitry. So when we try to use the Shockley's equation, see Shockley's equation, ye jo main topic hai iska actual connect aapka electronic devices se hai. Lekin abhi hum log iska forward bias current agar humko calculate karna hai with the data given ki reverse current itna hai aur diode ke liye drop itna hai aur is temperature pe hai, to aisa ho sakta hai ki circuitry diya hai aur diode ke parameters kuch diye hai, तो उसकी मदद से हम वो डायोड का करंट निकालेंगे और उससे रिलेटेड कुछ सर्किट सॉल्व हो जाएगा. सो इसीलिए हम ये चीज देख रहे हैं कि जो शॉकलेस इक्वेशन है उसका सिग्निफिकेंस एक्चुअली ये है. ओके, या इंग्लिश, आई एम सॉरी, या सो दैट्स द मेन सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द टर्म दैट इज शॉकलेस इक्वेशन. हियर वी आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू गो फॉर द करंट इक्वेशन. सो द करंट इक्वेशन विल बी यूज्ड for solving a particular circuitry. See, it's not like we are going to use the Shockley's equation and again in every possible analog circuitry. That's not true. It's a event where a parameter will be given to you, like the forward drop, and we will be given a circuitry and a particular temperature is being maintained. So under the situation, if the data is significant and we can find a diode current, and using the diode current, we will be able to solve the sums. So that's the main reason for getting or discussing this equation. Okay, so I will proceed further. So here we are trying to understand the important parameters of the diode device. So the first element we are trying to discuss here is the static resistance. So this is the resistance offered by the diode under the impact of forward bias, or you can say a battery that is going to make the device as forward bias. I'll be definitely trying to cover the questions from the branches for which we are offering a course. So I hope please stay connected with me and be with me. That's more important. Don't worry. So coming back, we are talking about the impact of static resistance. So whenever we talk about the static resistance, it is the resistance offered by the diode under forward bias. So whenever we talk about a forward bias effect, it's very simple and understandable that a diode is connected to a battery. So there is a constant drop. So it will have a fixed value of the forward voltage, and there will be a current flowing through the diode. If we know the current and the voltage parameter of the diode, we will get the static or the resistance of that particular point. If you see the curve, the current and the voltage are actually intersecting the curve at a particular point. So we are going to get a resistance at that point. So that is what we mean by the static, or you can say it is, on simple terms, the DC resistance of the diode. The next is the dynamic resistance. The dynamic resistance corresponds to the, you can say, the AC behavior. So it is going to be rate of change of the voltage with respect to the rate of change of current. You'll get the value of the dynamic resistance. Normally, dynamic resistance is found out using a standard formula, that is VT by IDQ, where IDQ is the DC current and VT is the thermal voltage. So you can find that resistance using the formula VT by IDQ. IDQ either we need to find from the question somehow, or we will be given some data from where we can get IDQ. And VT, standardized value 26 millivolt. If not standardized given, then it will be covering in the data. So from the data, we have to take the value of VT. So this is important. We are going to see the impact of equivalent model of the diode under forward bias. If you see the idealistic behavior, it will be just like a closed switch effect, and there will be nothing to do because the drop across the diode will be considered as zero. But when we talk about the practical arrangement, you will be having the diode as a closed switch effect followed by the drop of the diode. That is going to be approximately 0.7 or something. That depends, as I've said, on the device or the diode device we are going to use, silicon or germanium, or any other combo device is also possible. And then the resistance, that is the RF resistance, that's the internal resistance of the diode under forward bias. So this is going to make our circuitry an equivalent circuitry, which is going to represent a diode. And it purely depends on whether we're going to use the complete equivalent circuitry or only the impact of the diode drop. That depends on the data. So we need to interpret the data, and then we need to create a replacement for the diode under that situation. So this is again an understanding with respect to the current and the voltage graph. If you see the left hand side figure, we are talking about the ideal behavior. So the drop of the diode is going to be considered as zero, and we get a significant forward bias current. And when we talk about the practical or a realistic diode, then we see the impact of 0.7 volts and we do get the forward bias current. So this is just the comparison between the ideal diode under forward bias and the practical diode under forward bias. So now I guess we are ready with some mindset so that we can solve sums. So let's go for the sums. So this is from the GATE 2000 EC paper, long time back actually. Let's have a look at the question. And the question says, determine the value of voltage VO as shown in the figure. So this is the figure for everyone. So the options given are A, 2 volt, B, 1 volt, C, minus 1 volt, and D, none of these. So I'll give you time to solve, and please update me so that give me a conclusive answer. If you can't get an answer, we'll definitely solve this. I'm giving you time so that you can solve it from your side and try to figure out which is the correct option. There are two approaches for solving this sum. I will give you a hint regarding how to solve this sum. The hint is actually very simple. You see the situation of the two batteries, and then you just try to analyze whether the diode will be under forward bias or reverse bias, because we need to start with an assumption. So we need to assume that the situation of the diode will be either forward or reverse. That's the first thing. And then second, when you try to solve this sum, you will be having two methodologies actually. One, you can go for the normal KCL methodology, where you will be using the current equations to get an answer. Or secondly, we can also go for the other method, where we will go for the source transformations and you try to get a solution for the value of VO. So I have given you the hint, and I request everyone now to to just put a little bit of your mind in this so that we can discuss this topic. For making the diode current to be forward bias, we need to see, since nothing is specified, we need to assume that a diode is going to be ideal. So under forward bias, it will straight away work like a closed switch. So that was that's the thing I was talking about, that whenever we go for the understanding of the diode, agar kuch bhi specify nahi kiya, nothing specified, you can take the diode as ideal. So under the ideal behavior, it will work like a closed switch. And if it is reverse, it will work like an open switch. Regarding how much current is required for forward biasing of the diode, the forward current is a function of the forward voltage. So the impact of voltage will be seen in the impact of the current. So for that, we need to understand what's the drop of the diode. If we know the drop of the diode, then we get the forward current flowing through the diode using the diode equation. I hope you got the hint of solving this sum. If you assume that a diode is going to be forward bias, it will work like a closed switch. So under that behavior, when you try to solve, either you can solve using the concept of the normal KCL, or you can also use the other methodology. I'll be discussing the source transformation effect so that you can understand the solution properly. No, we don't have to actually take two cases. We need to straight away question mein bola hai ki we are supposed to find the value of VO. Okay. So if you are supposed to find the value of VO, so if you see the option, there is 2 volt, 1 volt, minus 1 volt, and none of these. So we need to take the impact of the situation, the 4 volt battery and the 2 volt battery. If you see the potential of the anode pe jo potential aayega, the impact of the potential at the anode. That is something that you need to understand. So you will not see that there will be two situations. There will be only one situation, and the situation is going to be forward bias, because the 4 volt battery is going to be stronger than a negative 2 volt battery. So that's the reason it will always try to keep the anode of the diode to be positive, which will make under ideal behavior anode voltage greater than cathode. So it will give the impact of forward bias. So that's the reason you can assume the diode has forward bias, and you can take it as a closed switch effect, and then you will get the value of VO. Okay, so this is something that I have tried to do it from my side, slightly different arrangement. So if you see the left hand side arrangement, it is 4 volt and 2 volt. So it is like impact of a voltage source with resistance in series. It's a 4 volt and 2 ohm resistor. So what you will do here is you will convert that into a current source with resistance in parallel. So it will be 4 volt by 2 ohm. It will give you 2 ampere and the 2 ohm will come in parallel. And from the other end, you can see a 2 ohm resistor and a 2 volt battery, but then it is opposite. It's top side minus and bottom side plus. So it's like a current that is going to be pointing towards the downward direction. So because of that, we'll get a current 1 ampere going down and a 2 ohm resistor in parallel. So when you merge the left hand side and the right hand side arrangement, because now the entire network will be in parallel, so we can shuffle the positions of the element. So this will give you a resultant effect of a 1 ampere current moving on the top direction and the 2 ohm and the 2 ohm coming in parallel, which will be giving you 1 ohm. So if you see the resultant circuitry, will look something like this. 1 ampere current source with 1 ohm resistance in parallel will be again converted back to a 1 volt source with 1 ohm resistance. So current source and resistance in parallel got converted into a voltage source with resistance in series. So you will find that the arrangement of the Thevenins will give you this result. And then since we are consuming that a diode is going to be ideal diode, because the data is not specifying regarding the specifications of the diode, so we have to assume that a diode is going to be forward bias, because if you see the situation, it's a positive voltage connected to the anode, which will definitely make the anode potential bigger than the cathode. So you will get the value of the drop across the diode will be taken as zero. So the value of your VO will be the value of the supply voltage into the resistance, that is 2 ohm, divided by the addition of resistance. That's a simple now potential divider arrangement. So that's what I have discussed here. Yeah, someone has already given the answer as 2 by 3. That's absolutely right. So if you see the Thevenin's equivalent concept, where you will take the one current that is 2 ampere going upward and I2 current that will be 1 ampere that will be downward. So the resultant current will be actually 1 ampere. And when we solve it for the value of VO using a normal potential divider, you'll get the value of your VO as 2 by 3. So if you get the value of VO as 2 by 3, when you go back to the question and if you see the option as 2 volt, 1 volt, minus 1 volt and none of these, since 2 by 3 is not the option given in our question, so the correct answer is going to be D, none of these. So that's the answer for this question. So this was from the GATE 2000 EC paper. So the answer is 2 by 3. And for this solution, the answer is D, none of these. So I hope you got the point. So if you see, the trick was a little bit of trick on this. The other methodology, you can see that the diode will be working like a short. So the top node, that the point where the anode is connected actually, so that node you can justify as the Vx node, and then you can solve for Vx using a normal KCL equation where you will have three currents. So it will be like Vx minus 4 by divided by 2 plus Vx by 2 plus Vx minus of minus 2 by 2 is going to be equal to 0. So you'll get the value of Vx as 2 by 3 on solving. So that Vx will be straight away drop across 2 ohm resistor, which will be again as 2 by 3. So as I've said, you can solve this sum in multiple methods also, not an issue. The main target is to get the final answer correct. So now the next is, let's go for the next question. So before we go for the next question, as I've said, this positive initiative is provided by Ikeda for helping out the students. So if you want to take more benefit on this, you can click on the link https://ikeda.com/gate-registration, and you can enroll and get benefits up to 50% off. So that is something you can capitalize for getting a better scope of understanding of the subject and the course of analog electronics or analog circuits. Now, so this is from the GATE 2012 EC paper. So here we have a question. If we get VO as negative, then a diode is reverse bias. If you see the value of VO, the VO is basically the potential corresponding to the cathode. If you can go back to the figure, if you can observe carefully. Here, when we see the value of VO as 2/3 volt, that value, if it is negative, so that's a potential corresponding to the cathode. So whenever the cathode potential comes negative, and as per the arrangement, the anode is going to be positive, so diode is going to remain forward bias only. Wo reverse kab hoga jab, it will become reverse only when the cathode voltage exceeds the potential of the anode. So that's the main point I was talking about, that we need to figure out the relation between the anode and the cathode potential. For simple understanding, you can keep that thing in mind. Anode potential greater than cathode, it is forward bias. And anode potential less than the cathode, it will be reverse bias. So please keep that thing in mind so that it will help you for solving few more sums on this. So, so this question is from the GATE 2012 EC paper. So we have a question. It says the current voltage characteristics of the diode in the circuitry given below are I is equal to V minus 0.7 by 500 ampere for V greater than or equal to 0.7 volt, and it is going to be 0 for V less than 0.7 volt. And we are given a diagram here where a 10 volt battery is connected to a diode via the 1 kilo ohm resistor, and there is a current I flowing through the diode, and the drop across diode is V. So basically, when you see the equation is the relation between the current and the voltage of the diode actually. So that does not mean that we have to directly go back to the equation of the Shockley's and try to solve it using that logic. We need not go for that. We need to just stick what is being asked in the question. Let's see what's asked in the question. The question is, you are supposed to find the current in the circuitry. So our target is to find the value of current I, or you can say the I is the current given by the battery, or it's the current that is flowing through the diode. So we need to figure out what's the current in the loop, that is your I. So we will, okay, we'll solve it also. That's great. So someone has already solved it. It is 6.2 milliampere. That's right. But then we need to solve it for everyone. So how you will solve it? Let's check. So when we go for the solution, here I will directly go for the solution for everyone. So since the diode is under the forward bias, now it's understandable that the diode is connected to a battery with anode to the plus plate and the cathode to the negative plate. So but obvious that it is going to make the diode as forward bias. So that's the reason we are taking the diode as forward bias. So we need to apply a normal KVL to the circuitry. So when we apply the KVL to the equation circuitry, we will get plus 10 minus of I into 1K, that is 1000, minus V is equal to 0. So that's a standard KVL equation when you go in the clockwise direction, starting from one end of the battery and then completing the loop and reaching at the same point. So it is plus 10 minus I into 1000, the 1000 is corresponding to the 1K value, minus V is equal to the 0. Now we will put the value of I, because since the diode is forward bias and the equation of current is given as V minus 0.7 by 500 for V greater than equal to 0.7. So the second relation, that is 0 ampere for V less than 0.7, is actually irrelevant for us. So once we substitute that logic, V minus 0.7 upon 500 in that value of I, so solving that, we get the value of V as 3.8 volt. So on solving the value as 3.8, we got the value of V as 3.8. So once we get that value of V as 3.8, we can put that in the value of I, because I is having a standard relation, V minus 0.7 upon 500. So you can get, on putting the value of V as 3.8, the 6.2 milliampere. So the answer is answer D. 6.2 milliampere. So this is how you solve this question. So very simple sum actually, but it might look complicated because we need to interpret the situation. We need to figure out what's there in that question. So the question was regarding the current I, So when we talk about the current I, we need to solve using the standard KVL equation, and we just need to put that value of definition of I, that's the data part given to us, and we will get it as 6.2 milliampere. So that's the answer. So this is from the GATE 2020 instrumentation paper. So let's have a look at the question. So this is a question given to us. The question says, assume the diodes in the circuitry shown are ideal. The current Ix flowing through 3 kilo ohm resistor. In the bracket, they are specifying we need to put when we go for the substitution part in your system. It has to be in milliampere unit, and we can round it off to one decimal place. So we are supposed to find the value of Ix current, that is the current flowing through the center resistance of 3 kilo. So how do we solve this? Isko kaise solve kare? Okay, how do we solve this? So I'll be giving you a minute so that you can think on it, and we will proceed. So all of you can try. Everyone can take the benefit of the app. You can download the Ikeda application to get 1000 study coins and use it to access the courses. So that's an excellent initiative again for benefit of the students. So there are so many positive prospects that we are trying to bring for the students. So everyone can definitely take the benefit, and you can also refer your friends for courses that we are offering from not only our stream, it's from almost all possible streams that there are there in the GATE. So there are a lot of courses available from our side to help students of any background in engineering. So definitely everyone can take the benefit of that. Someone just gave me in chat ki English mein baat karo, abhi Hindi, theek hai, okay, I'll try to help you out. Is it 1.8 milliampere? Okay, we will check whether you are right or wrong. So, good attempt. So, abhi ye sum ko main solve kaise karna hai? So, when we solve this sum, first of all, you can see the arrangement. So, arrangement ko thoda hame dekhna, study karna padega. So, पहले तो हमें एक notations लगाने पड़ेंगे. So, this is something that we can put from our side. We can put some notations, diode D1, D2, D3, D4 and D5. And the two node potentials P and Q are there. So, now what we need to check is what's happening at the Q end. The node Q end, what's happening. So, you can see there are three diodes, D3, D4 and D5. So, since all the anodes are connected to the positive voltage. Now, first of all, if you observe, at the top part data mein clearly bola hai, the diodes in the circuitry are going to be ideal, implies if they are ideal diodes, under forward bias, they are going to work like perfect closed switch. So, it is going to look like a perfect closed switch. Look at the situation of D3. When you see the D3 diode, if it works like a perfect closed switch because the anode is at plus 15, automatically the node potential of Q will also go to 15. So the impact of this will be there on the D4 and the D5 diode. So if you observe the D4 and the D5 diode, the D4 diode is having anode at 10 volt and the D5 diode is having anode at 5 volt. And you will find the cathode potentials for both to around 15, implies D4 and D5 will be reverse bias. So it's as good as D4 and D5 are actually absent from the circuitry. So when we solve this, you will find the value of the node potential VQ as 15 volt, as I have discussed that D3, D4 and D5, when it becomes forward, under that situation, the node will go to the potential of 15, the VQ node will go to the 15 and will automatically make D4 and D5 as reverse bias. So the steady state behavior will give you the node potential of VQ as 15 volt. So now, going to the next part, so we got the node potential of Q as 15 volt. So now we need to interpret the situation, what is going to happen at the other end for the diode D1 and D2. So it is controlled with respect to the impact of node P. So we are going to go for a small calculation. Or we are going to apply the KCL at node P. It's going to be your normal KCL that all outgoing currents from a particular node is going to give you zero. So that logic we are going to apply, and we are assuming that a diode D1 and D2 are now forward, because we don't know the value of the node P. So we are taking the assumption that D1 and D2 are actually forward, and then we'll find the value of the node P. And then we will try to figure out, is it actually both diode D1 and D2 forward, or something else is happening for that. So when we go for the equation, you will get Vp minus 15 by 3k plus Vp minus 6 by 2k plus Vp minus 12 by 2k is equal to 0. So you'll get the value of Vp as 10.5. So we're getting the value of Vp as 10.5 volt. So if you see the node potential of Vp as 10.5 implies that potential is going to have an impact on the diode D1 and D2. So when you see the position of D1, you will see the cathode at 12 volt and the anode will be around 10.5. And then when we see the impact of D2, the cathode at 6 and the anode will be around at 10.5. So it can be easily seen that D2 will be in the on state and D1 will be in the off state. So if D1 goes in the off state, implies even that branch is getting eliminated. So we have a single path now to solve, which will be from 15 volt to 6 volt, where you will have only one diode in the path, that is your D2 diode. But again, under forward bias, it will work like a closed switch effect. So it will be like a short. And then we are having the two resistances, 3 kilo ohm and 2 kilo ohm. So on substitution, you'll get the potential difference upon resistance as the value of current. So the value is 15 minus 6 divided by 3k plus 2k, that is 5k, you'll get as 1.8 milliampere. So as rightly pointed by gentleman, that the current is 1.8 milliampere, so the answer is right, 1.8 milliampere. So those are solving very fast, that's excellent, implies that you have done some work in the lockdown. So it's a positive actually that you are taking efforts in the lockdown, and it's the right time to put an effort, because when we approach the year end and the gate exam, it's going to get complicated. So it's good that you're putting proper efforts at this time. So 1.8 is the answer for this question, 1.8 billion. Let's take one more question. So here we have a question from GATE 2014 ECE paper. And this question is, the diode in the circuit shown has on potential of 0.7 volt, but is either ideal otherwise. So now this statement might be looking confusing to you, but it's a straightforward understanding point that if it is on, it will keep a drop of 0.7, and if it is off, it will be straight away open such switch. So that's the meaning of that statement, that the diode in the circuitry shown will have an on potential of 0.7 volt, and is ideal otherwise. The value of Vi is given as 5 sine of omega t. So the 5 volt is corresponding to the peak value of the voltage. The voltage, if you can observe, it's a sinusoidal function. It's like normal Vm sine theta or Vm sine omega t. So the value of Vm is the peak value. So you can imagine a sine wave which is having two cycles, a positive cycle and a negative cycle, with the top peak at plus 5 and the bottom peak at minus 5. So we are supposed to find the value of minimum and maximum value of Vo in volts. So for this arrangement, you are supposed to find the minimum and the maximum value of Vo. So we are given options here. Options have nepas. Minus 5 and 2.7. Then 2.7 and 5. Minus 5 and 3.85. 1.3 and 5. So I'm giving you a minute to think on this, and let's check if you can solve. The understanding of this question is with respect to the behavior of the diode. You just need to figure out that there are two cycles of the input, the positive cycle and the negative cycle, and try to interpret what will be the impact on the diode and how you will get the value of Vo. So that's a hint, small hint for everyone to utilize, or you can say how to analyze the sum and get an answer for that. So here, when you try to see the situation, so if you observe, when the diode will be in the off state, when Vi makes the diode in the off state, if you can observe, the value of your output Vo will go to minus 5, because the input is having two cycles, the positive cycle and the negative cycle. So the anode potential has to be negative so that it can be reverse bias. So with respect to that, you can see that when the diode will become in the reverse bias state, that time the value of Vo and Vi will be actually same. So the value of Vo will go to minus 5 that time. So that's corresponding to the lowest value of the output, that is minus 5. And when we talk about the diode being in the on state, so that time the diode drop will be around 0.7. So that's possible only when you are having the input as the positive half cycle, because in the positive half cycle only the anode potential can exceed the potential of the cathode, because the cathode is already at 2 volt. So anode greater than cathode is a condition for forward biasing that will be true only in the forward bias effect. In the reverse bias, it is going to fail, because in the reverse bias, in the negative half cycle, it is going to fail that logic. So the diode will remain in the reverse bias, and that's the reason the value of Vo and Vi will be equal in the reverse in the negative half cycle. So when we talk about the two cycles, the positive half cycle and the negative half cycle, you can figure out that during the negative half cycle, the anode potential is going to be less than the cathode, because the cathode is already at 2 volt. So diode will work like an open switch, because it is clearly mentioned that you have to take the diode as ideal behavior otherwise. So it's going to be open switch. So it's as good as the Vo and the Vi will become equipotential, and that's the reason during the negative cycle of the input, that is, which is going to be minus 5 of the negative peak, that will be equal to the Vo value, and that's the reason you got the value of Vo min as minus 5 volt. And now when you take the value of the positive half cycle, the positive half cycle will make the diode as forward bias. So under that situation, what's the maximum possible output that you can get? So under that situation, we need to go for a KVL equation. So when we go for the KVL equation, first we need to find the current in the path. So the current in the path will be the value of Vi minus the drop of the diode minus the 2 volt battery divided by the addition of resistance, that is 1k and 1k. That's the reason we are having 1k and 1k in the denominator. So that current will be multiplied by the 1 kilo ohm resistor, that is R2 resistor. So to give a drop across the R2, that drop across R2 plus the drop of the diode plus the battery drop is the possible value of VO. So when you solve this, the value of VO will come as 3.85 volt. So if you observe now, the value of VO comes as 3.85 volt. So with this, we can see the option is going to be option C, that is minus 5 and 3.85 volt. So that's the correct answer for the question. Okay, let's take a question from the GATE 2017 electrical paper. So we have a question here. And the question says, so this is from the electrical. So I'm trying to cover the topics from all the branches. Okay, so don't worry regarding that. Just be with me. So here, this is regarding the GATE 2017 EE paper. So electrical paper. So the question is, for the circuit shown below, you are supposed to assume that a diode D1, D2 and D3 are ideal behavior. The DC components of the voltage V1 and V2 respectively are, so we are having options 0 volt and 1 volt, option A, option B is minus 0.5 and plus 0.5, option C is 1 volt and 0.5 volt, option D is 1 volt and 1 volt. Now this is an interesting part, because when you look at this question carefully, the function that is being given or the supply voltage that is being given is basically a sine function. And we are supposed to find the DC component. So when we talk about the question is regarding the DC component. So the DC component is corresponding to the average value of the AC signal. So that's the main trick or the hint here. We need to get the average value of the AC signal. You can definitely try this question and try to get an answer for this. So I'll try to give you a hint on this. Let's see. So here, when we talk about the positive half cycle of the AC input, you will find diode D1 in the on state and D2 and D3 in the off state. And during the negative half cycle, you will find diode D1 in the off state, D2 and D3 in the on state. So what will be the impact of this? The impact of this will give you a result something like this. So if we talk about the positive half cycle, you will find that the diode D1 is forward bias and D2 and D3 are in the off state. So you will find the value of your V2 as pi by 2 sine of 100 pi t. Now why we got that pi by 2 sine of 100 pi t? Because the cycle is pi sine 100 pi t for the positive half cycle of the input. And then R and R, both the resistance are equal. So the drop across V2, the drop V2 is across the second resistor R. So it will be working like a equal potential divider. And because of that reason, you will find the potential as pi by 2 sine of 100 pi t. And at the same time, the signal is passing through the resistance R. So that time the value, if you see the drop across R, the first R is also going to be half of the supply. So it is going to be again pi by 2 sine of 100 pi t. Now, when we go for the negative cycle, you will find a negative half cycle of the input will give D1 as forward bias and D2 and D3 under the forward bias state. So that's the reason. If D3 is forward bias, it will short the second resistance R, and D2 being also the short behavior, whatever is the supply voltage that will be existing across the resistor R, and that's the reason you will find pi sine 100 pi t, the entire negative cycle across the first resistance of R. So now it's very simple. It's a normal calculation of average value, half wave rectifier average value. So the V2 average value will be Vm by pi straight away. So the pi by 2 is the peak value, and divided by pi, you will get it as 0.5. And for the first V1 calculation, we need to go for the complete cycle integration for the average value. It is going to be 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi. And the value is going to be pi by 2 sine 100 pi t and d omega t. And then pi to 2 pi, it is pi sine 100 pi t d omega dt. So when you solve this, you will get the value as minus 0.5. So the correct answer for this question is V1 value is minus 0.5 and the V2 value is plus 0.5. So the answer is answer B. So I hope I was able to justify the topics that I've discussed today, and you are able to interpret in a better way. And in the last sum, as I've discussed, the concept of average value comes into picture. So the average value calculation is very, very important from calculating the value of DC component. If you can read the question is DC component. So that is the main thing. So I hope I was able to help everyone and support everyone for the topic of analog circuits. And we will come again with a few more set of sums and few more data to be analyzed in the coming sessions. And on behalf of the ECADA organization, I thank everyone for attending the session. And take care, everyone. And we will meet in the next session. Thank you.